All right, let's do a quick X-ray interpretation video here. This patient presented being found on the side of the road and complaining of left-sided abdominal pain, but it's more like left upper chest pain. He's intoxicated and he has some evidence of some dirt in the back of his shirt, so he probably fell. Looking at it, the most important thing we're looking for is pneumothorax, collapsed lung. I don't see any. The lungs are fully inflated all the way down. This diaphragm's a little higher, and that's kind of odd because usually this one's higher. The mediastinum looks a little bit wide. That shouldn't be like that. It should be a little bit narrow, so that's suspicious. Clavicles look okay. Scapula looks okay. And then we start looking at the ribs, and so far in this view, I don't see anything. But then we do dedicated rib series, and that's when we see some abnormalities. So starting from over here, you know, you go down each rib, kind of like following all the way around, following all the way around. Oh, you see that? You see that, guys? Right there, you see that little crack? That's a rib fracture. Yep, that's one. And then you go down this way. Yep, there it is, another rib fracture. So with rib fractures, the worry is whether or not there's a pulmonary contusion. A pulmonary contusion will look like a whiteness area or a pleural effusion fluid from, blood, I'm blanking on the word blood in the inside, a pneumothorax or a collapsed lung or anything like that, so he doesn't have that. With rib fractures, the main issue is going to be that people have a lot of pain. They can develop splinting as they breathe and not breathe deeply, and they can end up accumulating plugging of mucus and then that develop into pneumonia. So they need to be managed for pain adequately. Use an in-center spirometer to exercise the lungs and fully inflate. And that's kind of it. Thanks.